Faith on Film, a program designed to keep you aware and informed on everything that's happening in the world of faith and family films. Now, a few years ago, I'm not even sure how many, but a few years ago, I saw a movie that, in my opinion, was the best end time movie I'd ever seen, and to date, it still is. In fact, I showed it to several pastors right here in this screening room that you see behind me, and they all were just, I mean, they're pastors, they're already saved, but it looked like they wanted to just recommit again because they wanted to make sure not to stay here and be the remaining. So anyway, I'm excited because I have the co-writer of that film on my show today. Chris Dowling is a screenwriter and film director. He wrote the screenplay for the film Priceless, which released in 2016, and directed Run the Race, which released in 2019. He, of course, is the co-writer, as I mentioned, of the movie, my favorite all-time movie, The Remaining. Now, Dowling was born in, I hope I say this right, Flowood, Mississippi, and grew up in Dallas, Texas. After graduating from the University of Texas with a degree in radio, television, and film, he moved to Los Angeles in 2009. Now, I'm not sure, but I think he's back in Texas, so we're gonna have to get confirmation on that today. Chris, welcome to Faith on Film.
Thank you for having me, Isaac. And I think we need to get you a remaining poster back there. I'm not seeing one. That I don't know, man.
That is true. I am a huge fan, of course, of the Kendrick Brothers, and have had my hands a little bit in their movies all the way back from, all the way back from their very first one, Flywheel. So, of course, they always send me their posters, and I've put them in here. But you're going to have to send me a remaining one so that I can put it up there, at least in my new place. I am moving to Texas, too, so I'll have to set up something there and put your poster, all right?
Yeah, we will. I'll hand it to you because I'm out here in Texas, so I will hand it off to you, Isaac.
So it is confirmed you're back in Texas, then.
Yeehaw, baby.
Well, listen, on Faith on Film, one of the first things we like to do is find out about my guest, find out who you are, how you got started in filmmaking. So you got 5 minutes to give us your entire life story.
Wow, the spiel, huh? Okay. I mean, the easiest kind of Cliff Notes version is always wanted to do something in the creative space. Mm-hmm. And then I went to University of Texas and I was doing some screenwriting classes. And then funny enough, my best friend moved out to LA, became to act, crushed it, is one of those guys that never stopped working. And now it's 23 years later and he's still destroying it. Although he moved back to Texas too, but he can destroy it from Texas because he's been doing it like that. I went out to LA. I did some acting, did a little bit of soap opera work. I was Chaz for a little bit on Days of Our Lives. The Chaz, the party boy. And then I realized I really wanted to get behind the screen and be writing. And that was more of my interest. And so, did a short film. I was very fortunate to actually create a reality show in 2010 that ran for 40 episodes on Spike called Repo Games, which is a whole nother story in and of itself. Mm-hmm. And that kind of gave me a little money, at least to pursue the screenwriting, and take some chances and do some spec scripts. And that's actually when The Remaining was kind of Rich Peluso had brought that to me to help fix and put my twist on it. I was actually in the process of running a reality show, and then that kind of quickly got me there. And then I did a movie called Where Hope Grows, which I'm extremely proud of. And the Hollywood Reporter said it was the first American film with a lead actor with Down syndrome. Wow. And I could go on days about that movie, but. And then from there, then I got Priceless. They had seen that and they called me. So I got to work with For King and Country on that, which was really awesome. And I don't know, man, it's just like they all start to blur together. Got to do a couple amazing documentaries. We did one called Asperger's or Us with my best friend. That's on Netflix. And then we were fortunate to work with the Duplass brothers and then do a docu-series called Asperger's or Us on tour with Asperger's or Us that HBO bought. And and sprinkled in a couple other ones along the way. Got to work with Tim Tebow on Run the Race, which was really cool. And now there's some other things that are, in the works and happening, and just released a movie with Nick Searcy, The Man from Nowhere, which we'll get into that, but I mean, just a very, very cool way that thing came together. And we shot it in 8 days, which again, is one of the biggest feats ever for a feature film. That's kind of the quickest gist of it. I mean, it was like once I knew where I wanted to be and what I wanted to do, and it's a process, right? Like, I mean, I say all that, but that's like a 20-year gap of living in LA where it was, working through it and doing it. And now finally I'm in the spot where I'm very fortunate where I'm having incoming calls through my management and stuff and able to, pick and choose the stuff I want to work on.
Now, I noticed that you've done several things with basically special needs, as sort of the background of that. Is there a reason that you've kind of focused a little bit on special needs?
It's funny. When I wrote Where Hope Grows, I really had no I had no in with special needs. I didn't know anyone with special needs. And in fact, I mean, even meeting David DeSantis, the individual with Down syndrome who plays the lead, like it was actually embarrassing. The first time I sat down with him, when we were doing that movie, my wife goes, "You got to go sit down. You got to learn everything about Down syndrome, and you got to do this, and got to talk to you." And I said, "You know what? I'm going to go in there, and I'm just going to meet the guy and talk to him like a dude. And if that doesn't work, then I'll go backtrack and figure it all out." So I got there, I sat down. It was the first day we were going to do just a quick read through of the script, and it was him and I. We sat down, and then I got the script. I was about to hand it to him, and I realized I have no idea if this guy can read. I just don't know. I don't know. And so I slid it over to him, and I'm like, I said, "Man, I am so sorry, but can you read this?" And he looked at me, and with so much flair that he has, he licked his thumb and goes, "Oh, Dowling, I already know it." And he just started opening. And dude, he had memorized almost all of it already, and it was
Oh my
amazing.
goodness.
And that I think that set me up for my expectations of like the expectations that I would put on people in the special needs community and how I'd probably box them in. And then unpacking all of that, getting to know David, who I'm very close with. We still text almost every day. And now I have a real heart for that. I got involved with the special needs ministry at my church. I've been doing things with other special needs communities. And yeah, now it's like, I don't know, that I'll always have a special place in my heart, that movie. And
Very
it was
nice.
really cool to give a voice to, an underserved community, especially in the church, that felt like they didn't have a voice. And I was, it was like, it was really cool when one day I was talking to a mom and she said that her kid and some other kids with Down syndrome went as Produce, the main character from the movie, on Halloween. They dressed up like Produce and wore an apron, and that was their Halloween costume because that was their hero. And I thought that was, man, that really hit me. That was like, that's really cool. And so yeah, so then
That's
it just and then the Asperger's totally 100% different, and the movie feels different. I mean, it's a documentary, but it's a coming of age movie more than anything. I think the idea with those is like it's not the movie about Down syndrome, or it's not the movie about Asperger's. It's a good movie where they just happen to have a character happens to have Down syndrome, so we get to see that worldview. It's a good coming of age movie where some of the characters happen to have Asperger's, so it's like we see their worldview. I think that's the difference. I think that speaks with faith movies as well, as how we should be presenting faith movies.
Absolutely. Well, I'll tell you what, let's take a break, and when we come back, we're going to talk about that movie that you just finished that is supposed to release, that released like a few weeks ago, February, what was it?
February
February
9th, yeah.
9th.
Yeah,
Fantastic. We'll talk
February
about
9th.
that. So, folks, don't go away. We're going to be right back.
Encourage TV. Family-friendly and faith-friendly content, absolutely free. Subscribe today and watch hundreds of hours of content on our streaming channels. Visit EncourageTV.com today.
Seriously, how big was it? I'm telling you, it's humongous. So it was bigger than a castle? Totally. And when you're there's so many cool things to do that you forget about time. No way. That only happened to one place. Go ahead, think bigger.
Thank you. Welcome back to Faith on Film. We are here with Chris Dowling today, co-writer of my favorite end time movie. But listen, Chris, you mentioned a story that was a bit embarrassing for you, maybe with the Down syndrome young man. I have an embarrassing story that has kind of a similar touch. So I met years ago. I met that guy. I forget his name right now, but you know he's the one that has no limbs, basically no arms and no legs.
Nick.
Yes, Nick. And he was on the show that I was directing, and so I went down there to meet him. And I mean, immediately they introduced me to him, and immediately I went like this, and then I just stopped and froze. I didn't know what to do. So yep. If you know Nick, you know how loving he is. He looks at me and he goes, "Dude, just hug me." I did not know know where to hide myself. But so anyway, I think that was even more embarrassing than your story.
Yeah, you probably got me on that.
I win the prize for sticking my foot in my mouth, right? Well, anyway, so you've done a new movie now, and I did get to see the movie, while it is geared towards men, I found it to be real heartwarming and heart-touching. I mean, I'm going to be honest with you, I'm going to admit, I teared up. I cried, especially towards the end. So it's not just, it's not a movie for men that's action and, you know, cars crashing and all this, but it's a movie that really deals with something very important for men. Can you share a little bit about that with us?
Yeah, I mean, you know, it's out now, mm-hmm. and you can get it on SVOD or, the manfromnowheremovie.com. And, mm-hmm. It stars Nick Searcy. And it was actually really cool. Also, we did it in conjunction with the Masters University. So mm-hmm. We had a lot of students that were learning along the way, which is amazing because we shot the entire feature in 8 days. I give all the credit to the director, Matt Green, fantastic. The crew, it looks beautiful. Jeff Henson, they all did great. But we, you know, there's in the faith spectrum of you know, the films, the Kenner brothers they do a nice job with like Courageous and stuff, but there's not a lot of movies that are geared towards men in this genre. And especially movies where, yeah, like, you know, there's a lot of unpacking that a lot of guys have to do with their father and vice versa. And a lot of fathers needing to unpack that relationship with their son. And so, you know, we wanted to write a very contained story that was character driven, that that you could just really start to see the healing process and the window of not waiting till it's too late to start that healing process. And it's been powerful. We've seen in the screenings, you know, a lot of grown men crying and come and talk to us. And so I think that's really important. It's also, I feel like, a movie that is unlike anything else out there, the way that mm-hmm. it's set up with a B storyline that's actually film yes. noir and a detective story about a man looking for his son and how they intersect. And I think there's something real powerful even in the movie where, you know, the son is having trouble connecting with his dad, but he somehow starts connecting with this detective mm-hmm. in this book who is, you know, looking for his son. And it's easier. And I think for guys that a lot of times that is easier. It's like, I can read a book and deal with my feelings, or I can do with it over here, but I can't do it with you, who the problem is with dad, or yep. whoever, you know what I mean? So for us, you know, there's also, you know, there's a workbook for it, for tools, for ministries and stuff. And we also have been told, which really liked it, it's really landing on millennials just because of, because, you know, the actor is young in there too, and just the feel of it, because it, you know, it doesn't feel cheesy or anything. It feels like an independent film, mm-hmm. but also because, you know, it's where a lot of these guys are dealing with their dads right now. We're catching them in the right spot. So it's actually a pretty powerful tool for like youth groups and stuff and the boys in there to deal with that. It's been great. And Nick was great to come on board and we're just excited to see where it still goes. It's a little scary for me because this is the first movie I think I've ever done where I didn't have a studio behind us pushing it. Mm-hmm. And we just did this one ourselves, man. We edited it during quarantine and we just decided we wanted to give it a shot and put it on our own. And so, here we go.
Well, I do have to say that, you know, since you mentioned that you shot it in 8 days, most people can get the idea that, oh, it must be one of those really low budget movies. I don't know what the budget was, and I know you did it in 8 days, but I got to tell you, it looks like a really well put together high end movie, if you will. And one thing that I liked about it is that even though it is a Christian movie or a faith-based movie, I don't even know anymore why we tend to use those terms, but it does have a Christian worldview. But as you mentioned, it's not cheesy. I can attest to that. It was just a great movie that anybody can see. And I did love that whole film noir thing. I mean, the going back into the days of the mafia, let's say. and bringing in that sense of violence without it becoming a graphic violence. I mean, it just was amazing what you guys did with that. And again, I got totally caught up into it. And yes, I did tear up. There was a strong emotional sense to it. Can you tell us again how people can watch it? Or yeah, you were going to say something?
Well, I was going to say, you teared up, which I love, but hopefully you laughed a little bit along the way as well.
Oh,
I
tried,
and I think Nick did a good job inserting some humor in there and finding the moments to give it some
there was. I got afraid a few times, you know, when you see some of that, those scenes, it's like, oh, what's going to happen? So there was, I just kind of ran the gamut of emotions, you know, but that was nice to see in a film that, as you mentioned, isn't cheesy and isn't geared towards that female audience, which most Christian movies, to be honest with you, tend to be. They're there to grab that female audience because movies, and I've said this before on this show, the way you used to recoup your financing on movies was you would sell DVDs. Where would they sell the DVDs for faith-based movies? Was in Christian bookstores. Who would go to Christian bookstores to buy those DVDs to bring into the family? The moms and the grandmas. And so everybody was gearing the movies for them to like, so they would bring home to the family. Of course, the boys and the dads, the dads would probably be like, oh, not another one of those. But this one really does get away from that. So I think you guys did a marvelous job. I'll tell you what. Oh, yeah, so I was asking you, how again can people watch this movie?
Amazon and you know, places where you do the SVOD on the streaming sites. And then you know, you can go look for the DVD or the the book at themanfromnowheremovie.com. Or manfromnowheremovie.com. I don't know where the will take you. Manfromnowheremovie.com. So. So you know, we're again excited to see the lives it's touching and just the reactions we're getting. It's pretty awesome.
Terrific. Well, listen, we're going to take another break and then we'll come back. We're going to talk a little bit about maybe what's in your future. I'm sure you've got some plans already of what to do next. So folks, don't go away. We're going to be right back.
YBL is an experience like none other. Whether you are thinking about a call into leadership and ministry or something else.
I would do it again in a heartbeat. I learned a lot about having self-confidence in myself as a leader. Even though we're teenagers, we still have the power and the capacity to change the world.
God can do amazing things in a very short amount of time. The material that we studied, the activities that we did, really helped us to see that.
Going to YBL and hearing from professors that are my future professors and professors now, coming to Asbury is really like a continuation of what Youth Becoming Leaders was.
It was really important having a group of people my age who wanted to do what I wanted to do. We kind of end up as a family, which is the best thing I think about YBL.
With Chris Dowling, just a wonderful screenwriter and director. I'm a huge fan of some of his movies that he's done. So Chris, we've talked about the movies that you've done in the past. We've talked about the one that's just come out a few weeks ago, but I'm sure there must be something else there already in your heart or in your head as to what you're planning for the future. What's up with Chris in the future?
Yeah, a lot of cool stuff, man. I've got a movie that there's going to be some news coming out on that was shot. It's a Dennis Quaid movie called On the Line. It's a true story. It's a crazy true story, but that one, there's news coming out. It'll be released here in the next quarter. I shot a movie with Shonda Pierce called Roll With It. I'm a huge 80s fan, and I just I love the vibe of 80s movies, and like it's just basically irreverent and you can just sit back and enjoy a movie, which I think we're so hypercritical now and it's tougher. And so it's a great, just kind of fun throwback movie. It's karaoke. We've got amazing songs in there. Got Michael W. Smith singing Freebird as a redneck trucker in that movie. And it's a lot of fun. Yeah, we got great songs. So also coming out either somewhere between late spring, early summer. We're still working on the details for the distribution on that one. And then there's a couple projects right now that I'm currently writing, two true stories that, those are happening, which are cool. But then there's another one that is the life story of little Jimmy Dickens, who, I don't know, it's funny. If you're outside of Nashville, a lot of people don't know him, but in Nashville, he's like so revered. And, in fact, if you're walking the Ryman Auditorium on the outside, there's like Hank and I don't know, Waylon Jennings and maybe Roy Acuff. And there's these statues. Then you get to the front, the box office, and there's one statue. And that's the little 4'11" man, Jimmy Dickens. And so he's got this really crazy love story with his wife, Mona. And Jimmy's no longer with us, but and it's basically, it's their story. And it's really cool. And it really gets into the Grand Ole Opry and that time period of country music in the late 60s into the early 70s. Mm-hmm. And so I've been, I almost finished the first draft on that one. Very excited about that one. And then I'm supposed to be shooting a musical in July in Nashville called Undone that we haven't really announced yet, but I don't know. We're gonna shoot something called so it's super busy, man, which is awesome. And my biggest fear from moving to, you know, Texas from California was like, you know, rise up. But I'm by far busier than I've ever been. Yeah. And there's stuff piling up waiting, you know, in the wings right now for other stuff, which is really exciting. So yeah, man. So it's like, I don't know. I'm excited with what 2021 holds. I know it's a crazy time for, you know, a lot of people, and my family's no different right now, right. But you know, I'm just holding out for hope and inspiration, and that, right. You know, we as a country especially, but like, just, man, we can find some levity and just, you know, some way to move forward. And so I'm hopeful for 2021.
Mm-hmm. So am I, believe me, I really am. So if people want to follow you, you know, just write you perhaps. I always ask people to write the folks that I have on, and sometimes even just to let you know that they're there behind you and they're praying for you, because I think that's very important. How would they do that? Website, email, what do you got? Social media?
I'm terrible at Instagram, but my little Instagram handle is Chris_Dowling_director. Okay. And someone could hit me on that. Again, I don't post that often, but it's fun. And you can hit me up on Facebook or whatever. I'm pretty friendly. That's probably the easiest ways, but I'm looking forward to communicating with anybody and always happy to meet nice people.
Yep. Yep. Sometimes you might meet some not so nice people, but hey, if they pray for you, that's okay.
I'm not looking forward to it.
Well, listen, again, it was very exciting for me to have you on, because you've again written one of my favorite end time movies, and I really want to recommend it. If you can find that, I'm sure you can find it on Amazon and all kinds of places. The Remaining. It's not a movie that you want to see with your 5-year-old kid, but if they're 12, if they're 12 and over, no problem. It's a great movie. And of course, this one, I really recommend that you watch it with your son or your dad, or your grandfather. Yeah. In fact, all of you guys watch it. All you grandpa, father, son, all of you watch it together. It's a very, very, very good movie. And yet, just because I teared up doesn't mean that it's one of those soft movies, by the way. It's not at all. It's just very emotional. So it definitely has
some... It just means that you have a soft heart.
I do. And I try to hide it sometimes, but I can't. Oh, well. I is who I is. Well, folks, hey, listen, thank you so much for taking the time, Chris, to be with us. It looks like you got so much going on, but I appreciate you taking these few moments to come and share with our viewers about what you're doing. And again, viewers, make sure and follow him and just let him know you're there. Throw him a little message that says, hey, I'm here. I'm praying for you. You're doing great work. All righty. Yeah. Thank you so much, Chris.
Thank you. I appreciate it, brother.
You bet. Don't go away, folks. We're going to be right back.
Encourage TV. family-friendly and faith-friendly content absolutely free. Subscribe today and watch hundreds of hours of content on our streaming channels. Visit EncourageTV.com today.
Dad? This is a lot of work. It might take us the entire weekend.
You think this is rough?
Try building one of the most massive wooden ships in history without modern tools. Go ahead. Think bigger.
Welcome back to Faith on Film. Thank you for tuning in to today's show. I highly recommend that you find and check out that movie, The Remaining. Watch it with your friends, with your family, with your neighbors. Just get out there and watch it. You won't regret it. And also, of course, the movie that just recently came out, Man from Nowhere. Man from Nowhere. It's a great movie. And again, I recommend you watch it with your son, your grandson. Just get out there and watch it, okay? And of course, remember, I really want to hear from you. So write me at faithonfilmtv@gmail.com. That's faithonfilmtv@gmail.com. You can always follow me also on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at Faith on Film TV. And don't forget to check out Parables TV, a place where you can watch all sorts of great content, movies, documentaries, reality shows, children's shows, just a lot of great content for you and your family. All you have to do is go to parables.tv and register for free. That's parables.tv. Well, until next week, take care.